on, I am in my crazy kitchen of chaos. And I have two buckets to fill here. And I do have one bucket filled, but I didn't fill it. I was just throwing stuff in it to just have it, to put it somewhere. So I don't know if you can see this or not, but we've got a ton of canned goods to go through. I've got all kinds of stuff to do here. So we're going to fill this bucket first. And what we're going to do is we're going to look at the products and we're going to divide some of the mainstay stuff that we have in either one. So first of all, I have this cornmeal, and it is, I found it on reduced for $2. So we're going to put some cornmeal down in there. I am going to put both of these very small packages of rice. I have one basmati and one jasmine, and these I got on sale and had a coupon for. So we're going to put some rice down in that bucket. Okay, so before I go with all of that, I want to put some of my bigger stuff in there. And in the middle of this bucket, I am going to put some oat milk. It says milked oats. Okay, so that's going to go right in the middle of my bucket. I am also going to put this one. This is a flax milk with protein. We're going to put that one in there as well. Now we're going to fill in around the sides. I am going to put a golden mushroom and a beef gravy in here. Okay, so we're going to put a couple more things in there. I am going to put the applewood bacon baked beans. This is a huge one. I'm going to put that one in here. Okay. And then I'm going to put one of the Lux Pinto beans in here. I am going to put one thing of spaghetti. Okay, so I'm going to rearrange it a little bit. I mean, it's constantly in work, right? So we're going to put a Hungry Jack pancake and waffle mix. I think it's pancake mix. And it's just to add water. So we're going to put that down in there. Always adjusting. I mean, it's what it's all about. Just trying to fit as much in that bucket as you can. Something else I'm going to put in this bucket here. I'm going to put some Quick Oats in there. Okay. Now, hold one moment. Okay, so we have, let me see if I can get it to where you can see where we are. You can see there are some holes yet, and we're going to fill them holes with stuff for this bucket. Okay, I'm going to put a pot roast chunky soup in there. I'm going to put two of these Knorr vegetable bouillons, so that way we have broth for whatever we're going to use it with in here. I'm going to put some of these fruit snacks, these wonderful dried fruit snacks down in here. I have a few more to put down in there. I'm just going to fill in the holes. Now, something I didn't do, which I normally do when I'm filling a bucket for, you know, longer term, is to take the pancake mix out of the box. But just in case I need it this winter, I'm going to have that available to me. So, let's see here. We have some instant potatoes we're going to shove down in here. I don't have any fruit in there yet. Let's see. What kind of fruit do I have? How about And applesauce. We'll put a thing of applesauce down in there. So that's close to about all I can put in there. But I think I can get like maybe one of these ramen noodles. Yeah, I did. So there you go. There's one bucket. And that's a pretty heavy one, but not too bad. Okay, so let's do our second bucket here. Now this one I'm kind of wanting to do a little lighter. I want this to be foods that we can just grab and go. There will be some canned food. I mean, you do need a couple cans of soup or something like that. We're going to put that in there. But it's going to be a lot more lighter type food in there. Okay, so first things first is I'm going to get my cans in this bucket first. We're going to do a chickpea and noodle high protein soup. We're going to do a Dinty Moore beef stew. We are going to do a Hormel chili. Now remember, I get all of my food on sale, discounted, reduced, or with coupons. So big thing for me. Okay. I'm going to put that one in there. Let's do some refried beans down in there. And what I want to do with this one is I want to put a ring of cans around the bottom. So I'm picking, you know, really good things to put down there. I really don't want to use this tuna. I have other tuna somewhere. But I think we'll just do the canned foods and stuff here because these are those really good cans. This one here, though, is a mackerel. I think it's for the cat. Yeah, there's a mackerel for the cat. I got it on sale for $1.37. So that's his food. He will not eat tuna. I'm just saying. Crazy. Let's do a broccoli and cheese. We'll do a sweet and spicy baked bean. I'm gonna put that in there. Let's do a can of Rotel for the tomato factor. Okay, so right now I have cans all around the bottom, and now we're gonna fill it with other food. Okay, so I have this 5-pound bag of rice. We're gonna put that in there. I've got some egg noodles. I can't tell if I'm high or low anymore. Okay, what else do we have to put in there? We will put some spaghetti. We're gonna put one spaghetti in there. So I also have some more organic dried fruits. Let's see what is in the box, how it is. Okay, so they're like this. We're going to keep one out because I'm going to check these things. But these are our fruit circles. We're going to put those down here in between these cans. I'm just going to kind of put two here, and just kind of help move everything from not moving. Okay, what else do we have that we need to get in here? Okay, so we have another can of beans. Let's go ahead and put the jalapeno bourbon beans in. And a lucky pinto bean. Now, I just got these yesterday in my shop, and I thought perfect for my buckets. Okay. And then I've got some oat milk. What else do I have in here? I have a beef ramen noodle. I'm actually going to keep this one and put some of my other ramen noodles in because that one I've never tasted before. And obviously with most ramen noodles, I know what they taste like. So I've got three here. Clear this box out. Whoops. So I've got three beef ramen noodles to go in there. I tell you what, I think I'm becoming a master at being able to puzzle and push and just get everything fitting in there just right. We have another thing of dried fruit snacks. Let's put those down in there. Now, what we're going to do is we're going to see what we can get out of here at the north side. Okay, so there's one. And three north sides to go into that bucket. I don't think we're getting anywhere. All right, so there you go. There's our second bucket. And this is what I do when it gets too filled, because this being the newer food, it is what can go into the buckets first, right? Hey, y'all have a great day. Hugs from a distance. I need to go check on Cider. Raven stomped him twice pretty bad today, and he's injured pretty bad. So I made him some mushy food just in case he's got some, you know, some injuries where he needs soft food to go through his body. I'm very worried about him, and I love the little guy. Y'all have a great day. Hugs from a distance.